Hi, welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick. We do many various kinds of topics every week on The Shtick, and it's time for politics because it has become quite a talking point. In fact, the whole nation is talking about politics, what's going on. And my guest in the studio is Josh Burns.
Hi. Henry, it's great to be back here.
It really is, 4 years later, and the action is really pumping.
Absolutely, it doesn't stop. But it seems every time I get involved in a campaign, I come back to the shtick, and it's really nice to be here.
It is great to have you. And you're now the pre-selected candidate for the seat of McNamara.
I think most people wouldn't know about what McNamara is, but Melbourne Ports, the seat that Michael Danby's held for 20 years, has now been renamed McNamara after a very impressive lady called Dame Jean McNamara, who was a scientist and a doctor and who helped combat polio and also the rabbit plague as well via myxomatosis. So she was a very impressive person, and I'm really privileged and humbled to be the Labor candidate, because to get a chance to run for federal parliament, it's a pretty amazing thing, and I'll give it my best shot.
4 years ago, you ran against David Southwick in the seat of state seat of Caulfield. Yeah. So now you've gone a rung up.
Well, David, as I think we mentioned this last time, I first met David at my bar mitzvah, where he was the DJ, and we both did the YMCA, and it was a great time, and he did a really good job of that. Federal Parliament, I think this seat's a bit more winnable than coming up against David in the state seat of Caulfield, it's been a great journey so far.
Yeah, ironically, I met David the first time when he was running against Michael Danby.
Yes.
And then he lost that and ended up running for the state seat of Caulfield. Well, so it's sliding doors.
It is, and I think you know, it's like anything you do. You've got to have a go at something, and you get better at it over time, and you build up your credibility and you build up your skill set. But it's going to be a hard campaign in McNamara, but I'm excited.
I'm excited. You're currently working for Dan Andrews, the Premier of Victoria, as a senior advisor. Is that right?
I am. I'm very lucky to be working for Daniel Andrews. He's a great guy. In fact, I even had the privilege of going with him to Israel last year, where he opened up a trade office in Israel. And I think that's been one of the great things about Daniel Andrews is that, you know, he's obviously done so much. I'm not going to go into the level crossings and all of that stuff. But on Israel, Daniel always has understood that Israel, it's not just about their security situation, but that as a country, they're a partner in economics and innovation and in technology. And he opened up the first Australian state business office in Tel Aviv. And I was there, and it's doing good work, focusing on biomedicine and biotechnology. It's really, really good stuff.
You were with him when he met the Prime Minister of Israel.
Yes. It was a pretty unforgettable occasion to go in and be in the Prime Minister's office and meet Bibi and managed to get a photo as well.
Yeah, we'll flash that up.
he spoke about a whole lot of different things, and one of the interesting things he spoke about was how Israel is more and more selling things and have got things that people want and countries want. And he was talking about how Bibi was going to be going to India with Modi, and via an Israeli filtration company, going to be filtering the water in the Ganges so that he and Modi were going to drink it, which was, you know, a pretty cool story of where Israel's at right now. Yeah. I'm not sure I'd want to drink the Ganges.
Yeah, well, I've been on the River Ganges, and you really wouldn't want to drink that stuff at all. But I know Israel's innovation is so cutting edge now.
Yeah,
that they've got so many amazing inventions.
Absolutely. And it improves their relationships with other countries as well, and also Victoria, which is being led by Daniel Andrews. So it's great work.
There's a new push now for infrastructure. We were talking about that yesterday, where the loop is being proposed.
Absolutely. The suburban route, the rail loop. It's pretty bold policy, and it's a big idea. And I think a lot of people have criticised politicians for not taking big ideas. And as Daniel said, he's not going to be the premier, or it'd be unlikely if he's the premier to open up the suburban rail loop. But he's the
one.
It's going
to take 20 years or something.
It's going to take decades. It's a big project. But You know, if you, one of the good things about what's going on at the moment, if you look at the level crossings or the new train station, train lines being built, is that, you know, engineers are working on it, labourers are working on it. It's good jobs and thousands of jobs. And what that project does is that it doesn't just guarantee sort of a pipeline of work for the next few years. It guarantees lots of really good jobs in Victoria for a long period of time. It's actually a really important policy, not just for the train line, but for people who are going to work on it as well.
Yeah, I heard the State Parliament on television the other day, and Daniel Andrews was talking about opening all the TAFE colleges again, putting a lot of money Absolutely. Into doing that, which I think is really important.
Well, you know, one of the things he's going to be able to say is that what did Daniel Andrews do? Well, he made TAFE free, and he's made 30 priority courses free as of starting from next year, I believe. So that's a state-changing piece of policy, and it's a really Labor thing of policy. It reminds me of Gough a bit, where he made, you know, university free. It's something that I think a lot of people who worked on it will be really proud of.
In the pre-selection, you were also competing with Nick Dreyfuth and Mary
Dyrenforth.
Dyrenforth.
That's okay.
I can never say his name.
Okay.
Hi, Nick. And Mary. Hello, Mary. Was that pre-selection done on a local level or on the national executive?
It was done by the national executive, but there was a local ballot that they took. They took the result of that local ballot done. Mm. It was a ballot of the right locally in Melbourne Ports, but yeah, I was
you were very lucky.
I was lucky to say, look, you know, in politics sometimes you need a bit of luck, but Nick and Mary are both great people, and they both would have made good MPs, but in the end I was successful, and I hope to do the role justice.
Well, I'm very proud of you.
Thanks, Henry.
I'm sure your mother and all your family are as well.
A lot of nachas.
Yeah, we're going to go into the next segment now with more of Josh Burns, when we're going to talk about the current state of the fragmented Liberal Party.
What a mess.
We'll be back after the break.